cheating the sports, you cheating real boxing fans, you cheating with the weight. You know, and any real athlete, like I see like somebody like Shannon Sharp or these different people like that, those dudes know.
They know.
They know that this motherfucker already cheating. You know what I'm saying? But beyond the weight, he come in full of PEDs.
Yeah, we on Boss Talk 101. Yeah, we gonna talk.
I definitely know. I mean, a lot of people miss seeing y'all fight, you know, the fight fan, the page and everything. Like, people miss that. I know they do. My brother's one of them. Like, how you guys have transitioned, of course, but, I mean, do y'all not even care to even deal with boxing right now?
Not at all.
I know you had already told me you was at your breaking point.
Yeah.
This was a while back, you know?
Yeah, not at all, man.
I was kind of trying to figure that out. I'm like, the nigga just gonna quit, you know?
I mean, but you say that.
People still.
But you and a lot of people have no idea what me and my group of men, the LDBC, shout out to the LDBC, what we did for black boxing. And a lot of people don't understand it, and they don't appreciate it.
Wow.
You know, and when I figured that out and just accepted that, it wasn't. And then on top of that, the dudes that we helped in boxing, the dudes that we promoted and looked out for and showed love to, them dudes made tens of millions of dollars.
Yeah, yeah.
Some of them hundreds.
Wow.
So, I mean, I did what I was supposed to do in boxing.
Wow.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I still got to ask you about you. We went up to New York, right? And y'all already know this stuff won't end since we left New York. Mm-hmm. The what's his name? Garcia.
Garcia. Mm-hmm.
It don't end. So basically,
he got arrested.
I know he got arrested here today or something.
Yesterday.
But what they carried him out in a helmet with his shirt off.
Oh like my god. Oh my god. So
from that hotel.
Yeah, they put a helmet on him, took his clothes off of him
because he was drunk.
They don't carry you out of the
just drunk, yeah,
with a helmet on like you left them.
That's something. That's them steroids.
So what? Okay, but I just have to ask you, like, you know, when he came back and they start the drug testing. Why did the drug test come back late? Why they don't check it before? What is that all about?
Oh, that happens in boxing.
Really?
You know, yeah, that's normal. That's
okay.
The protocol. I mean, they don't. Boxing is a thirsty sport. It ain't no real regulation in it. It's animals and savages in charge of boxing. And so with that situation, at that point, a promotion has went way too far. You got to understand, it's all kind of money that has been poured into this event. And they can't stop it. Once it gets to the point to where Devin and Ryan was, and we get the week out, a month out, and it's already been millions of dollars put into the promotion. And if they yank that promotion, they lose ticket sales. They got to refund tickets. They're not going to get pay-per-view sales. It's going to be a complete loss for these dirty dudes. They're not gonna pull their money out of it.
But Ryan came in drinking a beer and stuff at weigh-in and
that's
all that.
That's not drinking a beer is not illegal.
I know, and it's not illegal, but it's still something that kind of
sportsmanship. It was weird.
But here's the thing. A lot of people get caught up, and I listen to dudes like make comments that wasn't even top athletes in school.
Yeah.
You know, they talk a lot of stuff. You gotta really understand, and then next thing, combat sports, fighting. They don't know nothing about no fighting. Just watch boxing. They don't even know what's going on. They just know, oh, he getting hit a lot, mm-hmm. You know. But boxing is very complex. It's a very unique situation. So when you looking at boxing, when you looking at Ryan and you looking at Devin, what makes these guys unique is that both of these dudes have been fighting since they kids.
That's what
I. So Ryan is not. You can say what you want to say about Ryan, but he. He's a trained killer. This is where it kind of gets weird. Unless you really with that, these dudes, all they do all day is train to kill somebody.
Yeah.
And so he looked like that, but that just looked like that. So when you get into a situation to where we just trying to see which one is better, that situation might just be the reaction time that Devin might just be a tenth of a second faster than Ryan. But for skill and them working, they the same.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? So it's just a little bit that's going to separate the two. And so when you add a situation where the first situation was, where he gets on the scale and he just blatantly disregards the weight. Okay, we already know they evenly match. He's three and a half pounds heavier than Devin. So he already showing bad sportsmanship, cheating the sport, cheating real boxing fans. He ain't cheating none of these goofs that don't know nothing. They just savages and at the damn arena. You know what I'm saying? Looking looking for blood. We want blood. Yeah. Kill him. You know what I'm saying?
I seen it.
You know, so
I seen some of them.
You ain't cheating them. You know what I'm saying?
I seen them.
But, like, you know, you cheating the sports, you cheating real boxing fans, you cheating with the weight. You know, and any real athlete, like I see like somebody like Shannon Sharp or these different people like that, those dudes know.
They know.
They know that this motherfucker already cheating. You know what I'm saying? But beyond the weight, he come in full of PEDs. on top of him already cheating the sport and cheating people. He come in cheating in real life.
Damn. I see Bill. He jumps out the car now, and he actually went viral doing that, too. running up to these comedians, taking to her. You know what I'm saying? They putting on weird. Matter of fact, Chico Bean put one on.
Did it, too.
Did it just like,
yeah,
right,
did
it
like him.
Did just like Bill, you know, just. Which that's all funny because he like Bill, of course. But the thing is, like, Bill is that was a challenging thing for him, you know, when you see how he it messed with him pretty bad.
That's his son.
Yeah.
I mean, and that not only is that his son, Devin is his biggest investment.
Right.
Bill left everything alone, and not just Bill, Little, which is Bill Jr., which is Devin's older brother. Them dudes invested their life into Devin. And both of them, not just the dad, but the older brother. They went to Mexico. They did all the things that they were supposed to do for they lined up and got in the Floyd gym. They left Oakland because, you know, the brother is a factor too out there. Damn. In Oakland. They left Oakland, moved to Las Vegas, took Devin out of school. Devin was not, he never went to school like, well, he did for a little bit until he was fighting so much that his dad was like, God damn, what we gonna do? We got it. He took him to Floyd gym, and that's where he met Big Floyd and Floyd Mayweather when he was like, I want to say 8 years old or something.
Yeah.
And so that's been their life. And so to get, and they know Ryan. And that was what was hard for me to digest, because what was hard for me to digest is that boxing is a sport. It's not the street. So they've known Ryan.
So it should have been more respect.
Yeah,
I get it.
You know what I'm saying? It should have been more respect there. And I'm gonna tell you something. I would have never put that on Ryan. I would have never said.
She said she did.
I would have never said that he was capable of that. I would have never
didn't trust that nigga from the jump.
No, listen. When we went back to the hotel, you know what I'm saying? To wait on Dev to come. First of all, how can you claim to be this Christian, this big Jesus, my Lord, this, that, and the third, and do all of this crazy shit? That's one. Two, that's how you know a fucking hypocrite they have behind Jesus. You know what I'm saying? Jesus, come out here. You full of fucking coke, PEDs, all type of shit. You know what I'm saying? Piss. Who knows? You know, you just full of it. And you do all these bogus antics against somebody. And this another thing that makes me mad. Dev don't do shit to nobody.
Yeah.
Dev don't do nothing. And motherfuckers hate him because and it's like it's people who can't even fight talking.
Oh yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It's people up in there, yeah, take this L, just take this L. This motherfucker cheated.
Yeah.
Cheated. He cheated, like blatantly cheated. Then on top of that, put out all this propaganda. Oh, Dev, y'all broke. Damn, motherfucking y'all one broke.
No.
Bro, broke his show.
We seen him at the hotel.
Broke his show? We went to the hotel after the fight, waiting on Dave. When was his jaw broke? Who broke the jaw?
He would have went to the hospital.
You know what I'm saying? Come on now. Dale was up there doing promotion. He was just shopping for a fucking jet. Your jaw don't heal that quick. Well, he got diamonds and gold in his motherfucking mouth. Where the wires at since his jaw was broke? You know what I'm saying? And people would take this and run with it. A couple of different reasons. For one, Dale already made history at 24. You know what I'm saying? Motherfuckers out here can't even pay their rent. You know what I'm saying? And this young motherfucker making history.
Oh yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. His daddy, nigga, you ain't shit. Yo, daddy had money. You mad at this man because his father was a father. You know what I'm saying? Don't be mad at him. Be mad at that piss poor son of a chop his nut up in your mama. Damn. That's who you be mad at. Damn. How the fuck is you mad at this man because he had a daddy? How is you mad at Bill? You know what I'm saying? Because he did what he was supposed to do. You know what I'm saying? He took care of his kids.
That's real.
Do you know how it is out here?
It's hard to get a dad. We set him down in that seat every day that don't have no daddy.
Like,
daddy is not helping.
You know, but you should take offense to that because you a real father.
Oh, for like, sure.
I mean, that also confuses me too. But it also lets me know the lack of leadership and the lack of strength amongst black men and the black men in the black men community. It's that right there is a very apparent, not just the losers that try to, you know, beat down on Bill and stuff like that.
Yeah.
That are mad because, and it's dudes that are mad that I've heard say and seen type, got a daddy. Who gives a f-? You know what I'm saying? Yeah. They just completely dysfunctional.
They're really mad. You got to understand that's a psyche thing where they hate because they, you know, hurt people, right?
Right.
So that person is really looking at that father figure and that dad because they didn't have one and it really pisses them off.
But
I'm being real.
But what get me to
it make them hate.
But what I'm saying about this right here is this is where I'm saying to go back to what I was saying about the lack of leadership. It's like it's so weak out here for the men. The men ain't even calling the youngsters or these not even youngsters keep calling these other men out. They not even saying that.
No.
It's always
they too busy.
In our community, it's always just like, well, man, you know, that's just how they are. That's just, there is no discipline. There is no recourse. There is no accountability. There is no structure in our community at all.
Crazy.
But at the same time, these dudes talk all that leadership and black this and black that. It's like, but you can't even hold, when somebody do something, you know what I'm saying? They should be held accountable.
Yeah, we on Boss Talk 101. Yeah, we gonna talk.